Citrine is the 52nd unique Warframe added to the game, with a kit focused around crystals. This video will look over her abilities, her strengths, weaknesses, and builds, so you can get the most out of her. I'm Nick Engineer, let's solve a practical problem. I've already covered how you get Citrine and how long it'll take in my previous video, so make sure you check that one out if you haven't already. First then, let's go over Citrine's abilities. Her passive is a regeneration aura, healing herself, her allies, and companions for 5 health per second. This can also apply to some objectives, such as excavators and defense operatives, but it doesn't apply to other ones, such as defense and mobile defense consoles. The healing that you get is increased by 0.1 for every health orb or universal orb Citrine collects, up to a maximum of 25 health per second after 200 health orbs. If the passive is yet to max out, Citrine is able to collect health orbs even at maximum health, just like when you're using Arcane Blessing or Synth Fiber. The range of this aura is affinity range, meaning it's 50 meters in normal missions. You can enhance the affinity range by using the Vazarin Focus School, specifically Mending Unity ability, for up to 25 meters extra range. However, the increased affinity range of the Open Worlds and Railjet missions does not increase the range of this healing aura, nor do Phosphor Flares. Now, health orbs themselves don't crop up too commonly in normal missions, which brings us on to Citrine's first ability. Fractured Blast sends out crystal shards to damage enemies in a cone in front of Citrine. This cone is affected by your range, and it's limited to line of sight, dealing a modest amount of damage with guaranteed slash and impact procs. The slash proc uses the entire ability damage in the calculation, delivering 35% of ability damage as true damage every second whilst it's active. When struck, enemies are also marked with a small crystal above their head. If they die while this crystal remains on them, they have a chance to drop extra health and energy orbs tied to your strength. This chance can go above 100% and this will produce additional orbs. The duration of the crystal effect, however, is not tied to the ability. Instead, it remains in place so long as an enemy has a slash proc on them. This timer can be increased by status duration bonuses, which Citrine can grant with another ability, as well as by simply applying new slash procs. This is similar to Varuna's Fangs of Raksh ability, maintaining the ability's effect by maintaining the relevant status proc. Strangely enough though, applying an impact proc does not maintain the bonus orb effect, only adding slash procs does. This ability is crucial to powering up Citrine's passive, not to mention it holds incredible sustain potential for you and your team through the extra healing and energy support. You can subsume this ability onto other Warframes through the Helminth system, though the damage and orb drops are halved on everyone else. Citrine's second ability is Preserving Shell. This applies damage reduction to Citrine and allied Warframes, but not to companions, NPC crew, or objectives. The range on this is once again affinity range, so it follows the same rules as her passive, including removing the reduction if allies leave affinity range, and reapplying it once they re-enter the range. The damage reduction starts at an amount based on your strength, and it can climb to a maximum of 90% reduction with kills and assists. However, the defense also decays after a couple seconds of no kills or assists. While the damage reduction is above 75%, it'll decay at 2% per second. Once you're at or below 75%, the decay becomes just 1% per second, down to a minimum of 25% damage reduction if you let it fall low enough. Recasting Preserving Shell will refresh the duration and will set the damage reduction to the higher value of either the current reduction or the starting value on cast. While this does mean you can theoretically maintain 90% damage reduction with minimum strength, strength also affects the rate at which you gain damage reduction from this ability. The base values are plus 3% on kill and plus 1.5% on assist, though the UI rounds down the reported value to the next whole number. The fractional damage reduction is still applied though, so 2 assists are always worth the same as 1 kill, and decimal increases or decreases do affect your overall gain. This is easily one of the strongest defense abilities in the entire game. There are some frames which can match or beat the damage reduction individually, so Mesa can reach 95%, but it's only against range attacks, and Eurani has an indefinite 90%, but this requires being on Merolina. There are also frames which can apply similar damage reduction to allies. Trinity's Blessing, for example, gives 75% damage reduction to the whole group, while both Gaara and Neja can apply 90%, but must target each person individually. For Citrine, she just activates it for group-wide damage reduction, requiring only kills or assists to maintain its power. When you consider that Citrine is also applying healing to the whole team in the same radius, she's immediately a solid support and tank frame. Further in keeping with the team support, Citrine's third ability is Prismatic Gem. Citrine deploys a large intangible gem a short distance in front of her, creating an aura with a base radius of 15 meters, which is affected by your range stat. Citrine and allies within the aura will receive a buff to status chance and status duration. The status chance is a modded bonus equal to your strength stat, while the status duration is also a modded bonus, but this time equal to your duration stat. On top of this, the gem joins the battle with its own attack. When you attack an enemy, with either you or the enemy inside the aura, the gem will target the enemy too. To trigger this, you'll need to be attacking with either your weapons or with Fractured Blast. The gem will deliver 4 hits of damage equal to your ability damage, which is modified by your strength stat. Those hits will be each of heat, cold, electric, and toxin, and all 4 hits are guaranteed to proc their respective status effect. These status effects are also enhanced by the gem's aura, such that even at the base duration, you'll still have 12 seconds of status damage per hit. The Prismatic Gem will repeatedly target enemies one at a time, with no discernible order as to how it chooses its next target. The only control you have is on choosing which enemies you damage, as the gem will target each enemy once per hit you land on that enemy. The gem will queue up multiple attacks if you target a group of enemies at once, although it will not attack the same enemy more than once for multiple hits within half a second, which prevents it from ridiculously scaling with multi-shot. Lastly then, we have Citrine's fourth ability, Crystallize. On cast, Citrine will lurch forwards and downwards, summoning creeping crystals when she lands. These crystals will target all enemies in line of sight within a hemisphere in front of her, crawling towards each enemy and incapacitating it in a large crystal. The ability can target enemies above and below Citrine, even with no physical route between you and the enemy, so long as they're in range and in line of sight. When struck, the enemies will also have a large crystal grow on them. This crystal gives you another location to damage the enemies, and by striking the crystal, your critical chance is set to 300% for that attack, regardless of what your critical chance was before, even if your critical chance was higher. This is identical to how Smita's Charm works, where that one forces you to a 200% critical chance when that particular buff occurs. In my testing, it seems that Citrine's 300% overrules the 200% you get from Smita, so you do still get the higher of those two effects. The critical bonus from these crystals, however, is a bit choosy. Radial attacks from AoE weaponry doesn't seem to get the critical bonus whatsoever, while melee weapons can struggle to consistently hit the crystals due to how the weapons are swung around. Precision range attacks, like from ordinary guns, as well as lasers, wide projectiles like the Archoplasmor, and from gunblades, can all strike the crystals for this critical bonus without issue. The lower your weapon's critical chance and the higher your weapon's critical damage, then the bigger the effect you'll get from aiming for the crystals. Just bear in mind that many weapons, especially higher crit weapons, will end up performing better just by aiming for headshots, rather than going through the process of conjuring these crystals first. Crystallize has a major weakness, however. It only lasts for a base of 8 seconds. That's the same base duration as Ash's smokescreen from invisibility. Couple this with a long cast time, and you may find yourself in need of casting this ability more often than you perhaps like. So considering her abilities, Citrine is a more than capable health tanking Warframe, with health and energy sustain options plus status spreading. Her damage output is fine enough for Star Chart levels, but it can be mostly ignored once you get into high level content, inviting you instead to use weapons which benefit from multiple status effects on the enemies. In this way, Citrine dissuades you from using AoE attacks for damage, as you cannot benefit from her kit as much with those. When it comes to using Citrine in higher level play, I found that using her 4th ability for control and damage doesn't scale amazingly well, again in no small part due to the short duration. Instead, she does better with a defense reduction ability to make enemies substantially easier to kill. You can take your pick of abilities like Pillage and Terrify, although my choice is actually Tharos Strike, using this build here. This leans heavily into the tanking aspect, utilizing Adaptation for more general damage reduction to stack with Preserving Shell, Arcane Blessing for a very high health pool, and Rolling Guard for an extra defense in tight situations, such as if you get silenced by the Violence Acolyte. While I've removed the crowd control ability innate to Citrine, the use of Arcane Eruption replaces this. Fractured Blast will be generating a lot of energy orbs, and between the 4 abilities Citrine has to cast, we can keep a constant flow going. This means enemies will be repeatedly knocked down in a wide area passively, further enhancing our survival. This is a heavy amount of defense to shut down anything any enemies might try to throw at you. For casting stats, Blind Rage ensures a total armor strip against all enemies, a near total shield strip, as well as generating a large amount of orbs and giving Preserving Shell 79% damage reduction immediately on casting. Prismatic Gem also benefits from this much strength, putting out more damage and nearly 200% status chance to our weapons. Archon Continuity is providing both a large duration bonus for the whole kit, as well as applying corrosive procs from Prismatic Gem. We've got Stretch and Augur Reach to give a range boost on a 1, 3 and 4, and Equilibrium allows us to generate even more energy from the abundance of health orbs being dropped, allowing us to liberally use abilities on all enemies. Given the amount of sustain that Citrine already has, there's not really a purpose to use Archon Stretch on this build. This setup also uses two quality of life mods. Natural Talent is very important on Citrine, as her cast times are very long. In fact, I'm also using an Ember Shard to further reduce the casting time. That's how slow she is. The other mod here is Preparation, to ensure we start with enough energy to get the ball rolling. By running Blind Rage, we've got low efficiency, so being able to use all of Fracture Blast, Preserving Shell and Tharos Strike immediately in a mission is very helpful. I also recommend using one or two Azure Shards for energy capacity to make it easier to cast multiple abilities in one go before you need to pick up orbs for energy. Citrine's base max energy of 180 would otherwise prevent you from casting both Preserving Shell and Prismatic Gem without a pickup, and could potentially leave you without enough energy to cast Fracture Blast. If you don't want to use Archon Shards, you can instead drop Rolling Guard for flow to get your energy capacity that way. For lower level play, where you've yet to unlock the Arbitrations and Veilbreaker upgrades, instead you can use this downscaled build. The approach is much the same, just weaker, as we're doing away with a lot of tank and passive control. We've got Vitality to ensure there's enough health buffer in all situations, and Flow for energy buffer too, all while maintaining the strength. If you're a lower level player, you won't have access to Tharos Strike, unless you bought or been gifted Styanax, so instead you can use Necros' Terrify. This will still give you enemy armor reduction and crowd control, or you can stick with Crystallize for the crits and no helmet requirement. For those of you at the highest of levels, you can substitute out Natural Talent and Preparation through the use of more Archon Shards. Two Talforged Ambers will cover you for casting speed, and then one or two Azure Shards for energy capacity, and one or two Ambers for a bit more starting energy. This would free you up to use Prime Sure-Footed for knockdown protection, and Archon Vitality for the health maximum and heat damage bonus, freeing up an Arcane slot in the process, such as for Arcane Avengers crit bonus. In a nutshell, Citrine's sheer tank, sustain and support, along with a relative lack of crucial breakpoints, gives a lot of flexibility in modding her. She's a very forgiving frame, especially with Archon Shards added in, allowing you to be a bit more creative. Maybe not Loki's decoy levels of creative, but hey, if that's what you want to do, then go right ahead. One other thing you need to be aware about with Citrine is that she's rather different from other Warframes in one key little detail. Most of the time, if you have two of the same Warframe in a squad, their bonuses will not overlap. Two casts of Roar will only give you the highest bonus, two Wisps will only give you the strongest motes, things to that effect. However, when it comes to Citrine, both her passive and her 2 can stack with other Citrines. If you have a squad of 4 Citrine players, you can potentially have a passive 100 health per second in the squad, and max out at 4 lots of 90% damage reduction for 99.99% reduction. This is potentially an effective 1 million healing per second, not even taking into account other reductions like armor. Given that this is quite unusual, this may be a bug, so don't be surprised if this does get removed from the game. The main takeaway is that Citrine is a powerfully resilient Warframe, applying status and enhancing your weapons, generating incredible sustain both solo and for a team. Her biggest weaknesses are in dealing with high level armor, which can be solved with a subsumed ability, as well as her casting speed, which can be fixed with Archon Shards. She's also not very stealthy, but that doesn't matter in the current Warframe meta. At the very least, I hope you found this guide helpful on how to use Citrine. That's all from me for now though, so as always, grow crystals, smash enemies, and fight well, Tenno.